Tonight, Biden picks Duluth. The presidential hopeful finally picks a campaign rally spot. We have the details of his visit.
And that stop could prove to be a pivotal point on the campaign trail. Why political experts are saying Minnesota is more important than ever.
And later, a champion for small business and minority communities. That's how one local woman is described as she accepts a prestigious award.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 10.
Good evening, I'm Kristen Bakke.
And I'm Anthony Matt. Thanks for joining us. Former Vice President Joe Biden has finally picked a campaign rally spot for Friday, and it's right here in Duluth.
The campaign for the Democratic presidential nominee released the preliminary schedule tonight. He will be at a union training center for a tour, followed by remarks. Times and locations have yet to be determined. We are working to confirm more details. CBS 3 will provide specifics on Biden's schedule as they're made available.
And it's no surprise Minnesota has gotten more and more attention from the candidates with visits and ad buys. Some polls show Joe Biden has opened up a strong lead in Minnesota.
In three polls last week, including the CBS Battleground Tracker, Biden has a 9-point lead. But Republicans and political experts agree the race here is almost certainly closer than that.
Esme Murphy shows us the factors making Minnesota count in campaign 2020.
In his visit to Mankato last month, the president put it this way.
If we win Minnesota, it is over.
Trump's right on that one.
Political scientist Professor David Schultz.
We really have become in so many ways a swing state. The fact that Trump almost won the state 4 years ago, the fact that he's been targeting it for the last 4 years or 3 years is all suggesting that.
Right now, polls show Biden ahead. A new Washington Post ABC News poll shows Biden with a 16-point Minnesota advantage.
I'm putting Biden somewhere in that area, 7, 8, 9 points, but still possible that it could deteriorate.
In 2016, polls here missed that Trump was luring Minnesota voters in rural areas and Minnesota's Iron Range away from Democrats.
In 2016, Minnesota had 19 pivot counties, counties that voted for Barack Obama in 2012 and Donald Trump in 2016. Beltrami County in northwestern Minnesota, where the president will be on Friday, is one of them. In 2012, Beltrami delivered a 9+ point victory for Obama, but in 2016 gave Trump a 9-point win. And let's look at Maurer County, where Austin is. In 2012, Obama won by more than 22 points in Maurer County. But in 2016, Maurer swung hard to Trump, delivering Trump a 7.8% victory.
It's one of those counties that speaks to the realignment of white working class America towards the Republican Party.
This time, Trump needs to get the suburbs to pivot, and Biden needs to get key groups like blacks and women to not repeat their 2016 subpar turnout.
The big story was how many Democrats stayed home, especially in Hennepin County. There was an enthusiasm gap there.
Well, Joe Biden will be in Duluth Friday. The president will be in Bemidji the same day. He's expected to tout manufacturing and jobs in the area. We'll be covering both stops online and on air, and we'll bring you more details on both visits as they become available. All right, Dave's here for a quick look at the weather. He's going to tell us how cold it's going to get in the morning. Right, Dave?
Yeah, and it's going to get pretty cold. Cold enough for a freeze warning or a frost advisory for all towns in our area. Now, today's high temperatures were a hint that a cool down was coming. After 70s yesterday, 50s and 60s, the best we could manage today. This is a look at the high temperatures we had today, which range from 56 in International Falls to 66 in Superior and Hayward, 67 in Ashland, one of the warmer spots we had. Tomorrow, I think we're all falling into the 50s as a cool center of high pressure comes in from Canada to clear us up and cool us down. By clearing us up, I mean it's going to hold at bay, at least for a little while, that western wildfire smoke. So that's a good bit of news for some folks who may have had that bothering, you know, if you have breathing problems. That isn't a good thing. Well, it'll stay away, I think, for a couple of days here. And our day planner says the price we pay for that clearer sky, of course, will be the cold conditions in the morning with lows near freezing. Daytime highs only around 56, which is cooler than normal. But we also have a warm-up to talk about in our seven-day forecast, and we'll have that chat in a few more minutes.
Thanks, Dave. After tough questions about an officer-involved shooting over the weekend, Duluth police now say the investigation into the officer's actions is open and active.
Police responded to an apartment in the city Saturday night on reports of a domestic assault. Police claimed they heard two shots and witnesses reported loud noises.
The BCA says Officer Tyler Liebfried fired his gun into the closed apartment door, hitting 23-year-old Jordan File in the shoulder. File was taken to the hospital, then arrested, but it was later announced he wouldn't face any charges. The BCA says no shots were fired in the apartment and they did not find any guns. Liebfried is now on administrative leave.
And according to the department's use of force policy, officers are required to use de-escalation techniques before resorting to force. They must exhaust every alternative and issue a warning before firing their weapon. They can also only use deadly force if they believe their lives or the life of another is in imminent danger.
When asked, DPD did not answer questions about whether Liebfried followed these rules. They also wouldn't say if shooting through a closed door with no clear target was in line with their policies. DPD did say the BCA is investigating the incident.
The St. Louis County Attorney will review their findings, then the department will conduct an administrative review, including looking at Liebfried's actions and whether they meet department requirements.
A new men's group at UMD held a peaceful protest this evening pushing for racial equity. The group Black Men Serving Excellence organized the protest. They're working to change stereotypes surrounding black men in the community and nationwide. Today's event was a call for justice for black lives and racial equity on UMD. Organizers say they want to raise awareness about the prejudice many in the black community face.
The goal of today's event was just to get people out here to continue to push and raise awareness for the social injustice that black people have been facing throughout several hundred years and show that we're not going to stand and continue to let systematic oppression put our people down.
The group plans to volunteer, visit schools around Duluth, and hold peaceful protests highlighting global issues.
A year later and trying to come up with an extra $100 million. That's what Essentia execs are dealing with as it relates to the Vision Northland project, now slated for completion in 2023. CBS3's Ryan Campo explains why this delay is happening.
A year since construction began in downtown Duluth, the now $900 million Vision Northland project won't be finished until a year after the original completion date.
We are on time with our new timeline.
A new timeline that has added 14,000 square feet to their blueprints, adding another patient floor and more outpatient care spaces.
This schedule is quite aggressive. About 26,000 square feet per day per month is what it equates to when you look at a 942,000 square foot building.
Despite the building going up with the pandemic ongoing, they've only had to stop progress for one day, but are prepared for anything to pop up.
So far, we'll say we're hanging in there, but obviously we're prepping for contingency plans if things change or if materials are delayed.
Despite the expansion, expanding even more comes down to care for patients now and into the future.
We found an opportunity to increase the footprint of the building for patient care, and we're glad that we did that because we are seeing a marked uptick in patient care over the past few months, and we anticipate that to continue.
When the biggest tower on the project is finished, it will stand 15 stories above First Street. It will also be the tallest building in Duluth.
Earlier this year, Essentia laid off about 900 employees across their hospital system. When asked, company reps did not respond to questions about where the extra $100 million for the project is coming from. In the past, they have said funding for the project comes from a fund separate from the one used to pay for staffing.
This morning, the Minnesota Bureau of Criminal Apprehension, or BCA, welcomed a new member to their canine unit. Soda, a 2-year-old British Labrador, joined the team as an electronic detection dog. Soda is the first electronic detection dog in the state. She'll be used to sniff out cell phones, hard drives, USBs, and SD cards. She'll mostly work in child exploitation cases across Minnesota, along with homicides and financial crimes.
These types of evidence are critical to proving those cases to hold those accountable who choose to try to hurt our children across Minnesota.
Soda was donated to the BCA through a nonprofit called Operation Underground Railroad. Evans added her previous training values at over $15,000. The BCA will be responsible for further expenses, including Soda's food, future training and any equipment she may need on the job.
Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, find out why one local woman is being recognized for her efforts in supporting local businesses.
Record high temp is 89 from 1948. The normal is 65. We're going to be underneath both of those numbers tomorrow with a cool down coming, but a warm spell is already in sight. I'll tell you when that could sashay in, coming up after our break.
Live, local, CBS 3 News at 10, with Kristen Vaki, Anthony Matt, Kelly Hinson, and weather with meteorologist Dave Anderson on Live, local, CBS 3. Watch Jeopardy at 4:30, followed by CBS 3 Live at 5 on Live, local, CBS 3.
Honey, what are you doing?
Carpet's getting a little long. Tripping hazard.
Whoa, 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 whoa! Run! Who wants a brat?
Honey, just get in already.
It's okay to be a little overprotective.
Seriously?
After all, it's how we feel about our customers. Western National Insurance.
Shopping for a new kitchen at Skip's has never been better. Take home your dream kitchen today with Skip's new Glenwood and white cabinets. Enjoy freedom and flexibility with your own movable island today. You can rely on Skip's for quality and durability at affordable prices. Stop by with your measurements and see how you can take home beautifully painted or stained cabinets today at a truly affordable price. Visit us online at skipshomecenter.com or stop in to see our showroom at 4728 Rice Lake Road, Duluth.
Mediacom's fiber-powered broadband network was built for the future, and it's in your community. Delivering gigabit speeds to every home and business we serve, we'll be one of the first in the nation to take you to 10G, making your community one of the fastest in the world. The foundation is in place, and Mediacom will be making way for brilliant possibilities, igniting economic development and lighting up communities nationwide.
To learn more about this and other great offers, visit Toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
So, you made it all the way up to the North Pole?
Yep, and the South. But I need good Medicare coverage so I can keep exploring.
Well, we have a range of Medicare Advantage plans, some including dental, vision, prescription, and travel benefits.
Can I find them online?
Yeah, absolutely. Or you can give us a call.
Sounds good.
Well, my stop is just up ahead.
So that was the shortest ride I think I've ever been on.
Yeah, quarantine legs. Gotta work those muscles back up.
Watch Dave, Caitlin, and Austin for local weather you can trust on CBS. Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Cool down coming, all right. Tomorrow morning, our region is facing a freeze warning for just about everybody in Minnesota and for Douglas County, Wisconsin. Frost advisory rings the rest of the region from the UP in through the Bayfield Peninsula. So, going to be chilly. Gardeners, you may still have something in the ground. You know, the past couple of weeks have been a little bit rough. Once we got into September, the cold air has been coming, and we've had quite a few frost advisories. That probably put a hit on things. But if you still have something you can salvage, tonight and maybe even tomorrow night are going to be brisk as Arctic air takes over the region for a couple of days. But a warm-up is in sight within the next seven, and we'll tell you when that's going to hit in just a bit. Right now, we've got the current conditions from the airport in Duluth. It's 45 degrees. Relative humidity, that is 68%. Northwest winds wafting around at 7 miles per hour, and our air pressure keeps slowly increasing as the high settles into the upper Midwest. Right now at 30.21 inches of mercury. May stay on the high side through Saturday, most of Sunday. Next rain chance is Sunday night into Monday morning, and it's not a very enthusiastic chance at all. Temperatures right now in the upper peninsula go from a cool of 40 towards Watersmeet to 47 degrees around Ironwood and Bessemer and across the border there into Hurley, Wisconsin. Ashland's got 48. Hayward has 44. We're looking at 46 from Superior. Down the road to Solon Springs, mid-40s for Moose Lake. And taking a look at the North Shore, we're running anywhere from 39 up to Gunflint to 46 degrees, fairly close to Two Harbors up Highway 2, just a little bit. Iron Range numbers go from 36 on the Vermilion to 38 for Hibbing, 42 is what we have in Grand Rapids, and only 32 degrees International Falls. Bottom line for a range of low temps by tomorrow morning is upper 20s inland Minnesota, lower 30s for pretty much the rest of the region. Ashland may be one of our hot spots, daring to be as warm as 35 when we get up tomorrow morning. Happening in the sky right now, really not that much in the way of action. No, with the high pressure taking over, the clouds are going away, and of course that will allow radiational cooling then that sends our temperatures down. Now, speaking of going down, let's head to the south and take a look at Tropical Storm Sally, bringing plenty of rain, of course, from Louisiana in through Mississippi and towards Alabama and Georgia as well. Well, it's leaving Louisiana alone right now and starting to head towards the Carolinas. So folks there are still under the gun and could be until Friday in the afternoon. But our region, on the other hand, will have much gentler weather thanks to this high pressure that's pushing in. There's that low that brought a couple of sprinkles just the other night in that one-day warm-up. It's gone. Cooler high pressure takes over, like I mentioned, probably through most of Sunday. And then the next rain chance we get is a 30% shot Sunday night, Monday morning. And once that goes, it clears up again. But it also warms up. We could get back into the 70s again, perhaps as early as Monday. So we'll take a look at those days with our seven-day forecast and in Minnesota tonight. Low temps should run from 27 inland to 37 by the lake. Wisconsin and Michigan gets low temps from 32 to 35. There, and there's the Bayfield Peninsula daring to be 35. For tomorrow in the afternoon, Wisconsin, Michigan run mid to upper 50s for the most part, though the UP may only be the lower 50s. Towards Minnesota, mid 50s by the lake, maybe upper 50s once you get farther inland. But now, oh, the frosting on the cake. Here's the 7-day forecast. Starts cool, frost likely tomorrow, frost possible Friday morning. Then we split the difference for the weekend, get back into the 60s. Slight shower chance. We need more rain than that, but that's all we're going to get. Then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, the 70s have returned. Oh, get out and enjoy that while you can, even if there are a couple of days with slight rain chances.
Thanks, Dave. One Duluth woman has been recognized for her efforts in supporting minority-owned businesses here in Duluth.
Shaquana McIntyre has been named the Small Business Administration's Minnesota Minority Small Business Champion for 2020.
CBS3's Natalie Grant spoke with McIntyre today about the award and the change she is looking to make in the community.
Shaquana McIntyre moved to Duluth when she was in sixth grade.
It was the biggest culture shock of my life.
Moving to an area with not a lot of minority representation lit a fire to make a change to the place she calls home.
Just having to deal with that identity, cultural identity crisis that I went through, trying to figure out where I belong, I just want to make that a little bit easier for people.
McIntyre is the founder of a nonprofit, Family Rise Together, which provides programming and support for community members as well as minority businesses. She is also receiving statewide recognition as SBA's Minnesota Minority Small Business Champion for 2020.
The award is great, but there's so much work to do.
Work like supporting the upwards of 50 active minority-owned businesses in the city.
The next step is to make sure that I am a part of an ecosystem that is truly putting money in the hands of Black-owned businesses, Indigenous-owned businesses, and creating safe space for those businesses to exist in our community.
Creating a safe space in the community is something that McIntyre is looking to provide through her own nonprofit.
We have six spots where individuals who have at-home businesses who need to have a shared space to get their mail, come and use internet, do some printing on behalf of their business, they are now able to come into our office and utilize our space.
Over the past 5 years, McIntyre has helped at least 50 individuals start a business and hopes to continue that trend to many more.
There is not enough leadership in our community that African-American and biracial children can grasp a hold of and know that they have a future right here in our community. And so that's why it's important for me.
McIntyre's award coincides with National Small Business Week, which is happening next week. If you'd like to learn more about minority small business support, we have a link on our website.
Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, Hurricane Sally is now categorized as a tropical storm. We have the details coming up.
CBS 3 Live Cams are brought to you by Kohler Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac. You're not just getting a car, you're getting Kohler.
Slumberland's huge Labor Day sale ends Saturday. Get this stylish, comfy sectional for just $9.98 and get the storage ottoman free. Or an incredible price on the Sealy Posturepedic Queen mattress. Plus, get free shipping with no minimum. The Labor Day sale at Slumberland Furniture.
When COVID struck, President Trump took action. Cut off travel from China, the source of the virus. Joe Biden criticized, politicized, attacked President Trump's leadership. And what does Biden now propose while the pandemic still smolders around the globe? Increasing refugees by 700% from the most unstable, vulnerable, dangerous parts of the world. America can't afford weak Joe Biden. Times like these call for real leadership.
I'm Donald J. Trump, and I approve this message.
What are you thinking?
Thinking about burger, fries, and some pie.
You know it's 9 o'clock in the morning.
Well, then bring the pie first.
It's back, and better than ever. Perkins Burger, Fries, and Pie Combo. For a limited time, enjoy any burger, fries, and a slice of pie. And always served safely. Whether you dine in, order online, or get it to go. Order now at PerkinsToGo.com.
We are making progress in downtown Duluth. Lake Avenue has now reopened to traffic. Plus, season 3 of Superior Street Reconstruction is moving right along with an expected completion this fall. In these uncertain times, it's more important than ever to support our small, locally owned businesses, especially those in our construction zone. Whether it's a takeout meal or dining in, retail purchase or gift cards, they all make an impact in our community. Check out our progress and show your love for downtown Duluth small businesses.
Hi, I'm Steve Little with Bath Planet. Your simple and affordable choice for bathtubs, showers, surrounds, and safety tubs. Right now, we are offering zero down, zero interest, and zero payments until 2022, or get your dream bathroom for as little as $69 a month. This offer ends September 30th, so call us today or go online to book your appointment to take advantage of this amazing offer. Bath Planet, out of this world service and down to earth price.
Watch Jeopardy at 4:30, followed by CBS 3 Live at 5 on Live Local CBS 3.
Incredible savings on mattresses during the big Sealy sale now at Slumberland. Get a Sealy Queen mattress as low as $99 or a luxurious Sealy Posturepedic for $9.99 plus free shipping. The big Sealy sale at Slumberland.
Up to 60% off on summer clothing and footwear from the North Face in Columbia at Northwest Outlet.
My 95.7 is the Northland's best variety all day. From Ed Sheeran and Maroon 5 to Lady Gaga and Bryan Adams. Always family and office friendly. My 95.7, your life, your music.
Watch Jeopardy at 4:30, followed by CBS 3 Live at 5 on Live Local CBS 3.
Sally is now a tropical storm, but is still disrupting the lives of millions of Gulf Coast residents.
The storm made a slow but destructive landfall as a Category 2 hurricane near the Florida-Alabama state line early today with winds over 100 miles an hour and an onslaught of rain.
As it slammed into the Gulf Coast, Sally turned land into lakes across the region. In Florida's panhandle, the life-threatening storm flooded the town of Navarre.
We are trying to gather personal belongings that have been floating through.
Near Mobile Bay, Alabama, winds and pounding rain flipped this semi on its side. In Gulf Shores, close to where Sally made landfall overnight, the walls of this apartment building peeled off as Sally left destruction for miles around.
We started hearing all of our windows start to pop. Part of the roof started coming off and siding was ripping. We just rode it out.
We're going to try to survive this. We're going to try going through this. And we're just going to try to be safe.
Dozens of trees were toppled in and around this park here in Mobile, Alabama. Down power lines in the area have left tens of thousands of people without electricity. Torrential rain battered Pensacola, Florida. Some areas receiving up to 30 inches.
Looking at water of this nature, people should be very, very careful. It is hazardous. Do not try to go out in there.
The storm even collapsed a section of the 3-mile bridge across Pensacola Bay. Florida has activated 500 National Guard soldiers to help in Sally's aftermath.
Sally has left more than 500,000 without power in the Gulf Coast, and over 20 million people remain under flash flood watches.
Coming up in sports here, Northland reaction to the potential return of high school football and volleyball. Kelly Inseth is in next.
Watch Dave, Caitlin, and Austin for local weather you can trust on CBS.
Our current president has failed. He's failed to protect us. He's failed to protect America. As president, I'll make you a promise. I'll protect America without exception every time.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
I was diagnosed with diabetes at 13, so I got to work. I'm Quinn Nystrom, and I became a national advocate. Went door-to-door in Brainerd, then St. Paul. Went up to Canada to bring back insulin for a fraction of what drug companies charge here. But Pete Stauber went to Washington and voted against making healthcare and prescription drugs more affordable. I approve this message because Minnesota can't afford Pete Stauber in Congress.
Donating plasma is an easy way to earn up to $400 a month as a new donor while saving lives. That's right. Every donation you make helps patients in need survive and thrive. Returning donors also see monthly bonus payouts and iGive rewards points. Go to CSLplasma.com to learn more about plasma donation. CSL Plasma. Good for you, great for life.
Let's face it, it's been a tough year. But here in Minnesota, we're pretty tough too. We help each other, we work together, and we solve problems. That's what I try to do every day as your congressman. Like helping to save pensions for our union workers, standing with snowplow drivers during their strike, and fighting to lower health care costs for seniors and our most vulnerable. I'm Pete Stauber, and I approve this message because together, we're fighting for our way of life.
At Super One Foods, we go to great measures to deliver you with top quality meat every day. Try our Black Angus 80% lean ground chuck for only $2.49 a pound. And get Smithfield boneless pork sirloin steak or roast for just $1.66 a pound. Plus, we provide the best of the best in fresh produce. Get sweet tango apples for just $1.66 a pound. And 1 pound of California fresh strawberries for just $1.99. Through all that we do, we've got you in mind. Super One Foods, serving you lower prices and better choices.
Real steel. Find yours and find what fuels you. Not sold at Lowe's or the Home Depot. Pick up at over 9,000 local steel dealers. Find yours at steeldealers.com.
We can't deal with an economic crisis until you beat the pandemic. You can't have an economic comeback when almost 1,000 Americans die each day from COVID. Mr. President, do your job.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
A big day awaits Northland football and volleyball coaches this coming Monday. The Minnesota State High School League is set to meet to discuss the possible return of those two sports. CBS3's Neil Viersba talked with a few coaches to hear their thoughts and concerns on the possible change.
As high-risk fall sports return to practice this week, many of which didn't expect the possible return of the season as well.
I think initially I was a little surprised. I think, you know, there's a plan in place, and, you know, it's interesting that they're pivoting back.
Monday, MSHSL officials are expected to meet to discuss the potential return of football and volleyball to the fall, but the coaches have been down this road before and are prepared for anything.
I've got to be hesitant because we got our hopes up before early in August, thinking that we got a great chance to play, and they were kind of dashed. So I'm very, very excited, but still cautiously optimistic.
If the MSHSL goes forward with the decision, it once again raises a number of questions, including scheduling, among other things.
The match schedules, what's there going to be? What are we allowed to do? Do they have officials? I mean, are the coaches going to be available? I think there's a lot of questions, too, that come along with the decisions.
And with a high-contact sport such as football comes the injury risk.
There's a great group of coaches around this area. They're not going to put kids in harm and they're going to make the right decisions because safety above all, you know, that comes first. That's our first requirement as a coach is to make sure our kids are safe.
Regardless of the outcome on Monday, coaches know they have one shot to make it work.
We just have to make sure we do this right. We don't rush it, we follow the guidelines, and we all want to play as soon as possible.
I echo that, Coach Zag. Monday's meeting will happen virtually and is set to take place at 9 a.m. And some big news for Big Ten football. They are officially set to resume the weekend of October 24th. League presidents and chancellors voted unanimously to start competition back up. The conference feels they've adopted enough medical protocols to safely resume, which includes daily testing for student athletes and staff personnel. Teams will not get as many games as they do in a typical season. Obviously, teams will play 8 games in 8 weeks before the Big Ten Championship on December 19th. To baseball, the White Sox can clinch a playoff spot tonight with a win over the Twins. Twins 2 games back of them. Bottom of the second inning, no score. Edward Rosario, home run number 11 for the leader of the Bomba squad. That'll put the Twins on the board to make it 1-0. Those solo shots are pretty, but you know what's prettier? 2-run shots. Top of 4, Byron Buxton takes this one over the wall in center field. It's 2-0 Twins. The White Sox will have to wait a little longer to clinch a playoff spot. Maybe they won't. Maybe Twins will take the division back. Twins win 5-1 the final. And the Brewers and the Cards wrap up their 5-game series tonight with a pair of games. Bottom of the first in game one. Brewers bats staying hot early as Keston Hira goes deep off a Cardinals starter Adam Wainwright for his 13th long ball of the season. He's sneaky good. Brewers up 2-0, but the offense was quiet from there in game one. They go down by 2. Game two, a whole different story. They go on to get the 6-0 shutout. Some bittersweet wild news. Eric Staal is a 3-time 40-goal scorer who tallied 19 goals and 28 assists for the Wild this past season. He's been traded to Buffalo. He has 1 year remaining on a 2-year, $6.5 million contract, and he signed with Minnesota last February. In exchange, though, the Wild get Marcus Johansson, who is a 29-year-old forward who can play both on the wing and at center. Johansson scored 9 goals and 21 assists in 60 games with the Sabres this past season. Eric Staal, we're going to miss you. You were a solid but quiet guy with the Wild. Good luck in Buffalo. That's going to do it for sports. We'll be right back after the break.
CBS 3 closed captioning is brought to you by Accenture Health. Have our certified nurse midwives provide personal one-on-one support and guidance for your next pregnancy. Visit AccentureHealth.org to learn more.
Healthy Systems USA flash sale. 2-month program, 1-month price. It's like getting 1 month for free. Buy it for yourself or split it with a friend. Lose up to 1 pound of fat a day.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
Hey, Dutch boy, show me Mocha Red.
Okay.
Does it have a smooth, durable finish?
Yes, and it's 50% more stain resistant.
You still talking to Dutch Boy?
Dutch Boy, show me Sleepy Purple.
Okay.
Oh, would you look at that.
That's better.
He'll still help us paint, right?
With Dutch Boy's quality paint and Menards expert service, you can twist off to something great.
Right now at Menards, get 11% off everything, including Dutch Boy paint.
Because of this, we built Ford Super Duty to be the most capable heavy-duty pickup ever. Because of this, we built Ford F-150 with 375 horsepower. Because of this, we built Ford Ranger with the terrain management system. And because Ford trucks are built for this, you made Ford America's best-selling brand. Now lease an F-150 for just $299 a month. That's just $299 a month. Only at your local Northland Ford dealer.
We know it can be scary when you're injured in an accident.
We know the insurance company can be unfair.
We know bills need to be paid. But we also know what it takes to win.
We know what it takes to get our clients compensated.
And most importantly, we always fight to do the right thing for our community. Nicolet knows.
Injury law.
Nicolet Law, Duluth and Superior's award-winning injury, disability, and bankruptcy law firm.
We need to make things here in America. We rely on other countries for too many things. I'm Tina Smith, and I have a plan to rebuild American manufacturing, to strengthen our economy and grow the middle class. It starts with building a medical supply chain, so we're not relying on other countries for the medicine we need. I approve this message because instead of talking about making things in America, I've got a plan to do it.
Healthy Systems USA flash sale. 2 month program, 1 month price. It's like getting 1 month for free. Buy it for yourself or split it with a friend. Lose up to 1 pound of fat a day.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
Men's wardrobe provided by Mainstream Fashions for Men. Your fall fashion headquarters with new arrivals daily. Downtown Duluth.
All right, Dave. It's going to be chilly overnight.
Yeah, I think the range of low temperatures will run roughly 27 from inland Minnesota to 35 degrees by the shores of Lake Superior in Wisconsin. The rest of us in between that, of course, has set us up for a freeze warning and a frost advisory across the entire area. Gardeners, beware, because it could hit again come Friday morning. So higher pressure sliding in from Canada has chilled us down for a couple of days, but we'll start to bound back towards normal for the weekend. Next rain chances Sunday night, Monday, 30% shot, which isn't that great. But then the bigger news, perhaps, for retro summer fans, from Monday through Wednesday at least, we're looking at the 70s to come peeking back in, perhaps cautiously, but it should be here.
All right, we'll see you tomorrow.